Yeah, I thought I was going to have to call 911 in Astoria, Oregon.
Okay.
Over my sister.
So that city is really kind of in the tip-top upper left part of Oregon.
It's featured prominently in a famous classic movie. And my sister and her family, now they've done this kind of thing before. They went, they made the trek, they had this big cross-country road trip a couple of years ago, went and saw Field of Dreams.
Ah, okay.
You know, went to the actual field, right?
In Iowa, yeah?
Yes, did that kind of thing. And so they had to be in Seattle for my niece to be in a soccer tournament.
Okay.
And on their way back, they decided to take a little side trip, like 2.5 hours out of their way, to take the side trip to Astoria, Oregon.
Where?
And it was all to see certain sights from this movie. Can you name it? Do you know the movie?
Yes.
You have to know the movie, right?
Yeah, that's The Goonies. That's
the Goonies.
Yeah, the classic 80s movie.
Absolutely. Starts with, she's sending me these little videos. It starts with my nephew, Brady, is out in front of Mikey's house, Mikey and Bran's house, in The Goonies.
Okay.
And so there's a little sign, you have to like give a little donation, then you can walk up the driveway. And so Brady does the truffle shuffle, where Chunk is like, you know, like, do the truffle shuffle, no, come on, guys.
Yeah.
Puts up a shirt and shakes his belly.
Right.
So my nephew recreates that moment.
Sure.
Which is kind of magical. And then they're like, all right, next, we're going to go to the Fratelli's hideout. And I'm like, all right, great, that's going to be epic. And then, like, you have to, when you get there, you got to recreate the scene where Chunk's got his hand in the blender, right? He's confessing everything he's ever done wrong.
But the worst thing I ever done, I mixed up all this fake puke at home. And then I went to this movie theater, hid the puke in my jacket, climbed up to the balcony, and then I made a noise like this.
So, where are you calling the police?
Okay, so I'm FaceTiming my parents at this point, right?
Okay.
And we're like, all right, so I said, have you been getting the videos from Carrie? Like, they're on this epic, like, Goonies adventure right now as we speak. And
yeah.
They're like, well, let's try to call her. So we join her into the FaceTime.
Right.
So she joins us, and she's in the middle of a jungle right now.
Okay.
So apparently, if you look it up, the Fratelli's hideout, Lighthouse Lounge, was built just for the movie, and then it was taken down.
Oh.
But there's supposed to be like a shack or something that's there.
That's still on the site.
If you want to go see it. So she's like, all right. So we show up, and it says the shack is like 8 miles that way.
Oh.
So.
Wow.
They have like launched into this 8 mile hike. And I'm like, did you? 8 miles is a really long way. And it like this, she's shown us where it's a very narrow path. It is not marked. Like it's not roped off.
Gosh.
There's no sign that says, to the movie set this way.
Right.
Like,
right.
She's, and then they get separated. She and my brother-in-law, like the boys get separated somewhere. And I'm like, what are you doing? And I was like, how hot is it right now? It's 93 degrees.
Oh.
Do you have snacks?
Uh-huh.
Do you have water? Do you have backpacks? Like, they didn't prepare for an 8 mile walk one way. And then they'd have to turn around and walk 8 miles back. And so I'm starting to sit here and think, I'm like, listen, I'm laughing hysterically.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I'm like, listen, you're going to have to like drop a pin where you are, and we're going to have to get off because you need to save your battery because, oh my gosh, what are you people doing? So the good news is,
yeah, I was going
to
say,
after all of that, they did decide to turn around, get back to the car, and then they found the beach where, you know, you see the pirate ship coming out, and then they say, oh, that's where they rip up the contract, and you don't have to sign, and they stole some jewels in Mikey's little marble bag, and yay, that part, they found that.
That's the worst thing I ever done.
And then they did find a sign that acknowledges Lighthouse Lounge and all that kind of stuff. So we found all the major markers, and we didn't have to send out a rescue crew like I thought I was going to have to.
Okay. Well, that's good that your family's safe.
Yes. that's what my sister does. They do these random little, like, spontaneous side trips. And then she's just like, well, they said it's an 8 mile hike. I'm like, what? You weren't prepared for an 8 mile hike. And we were just watching before we talked to them. We were watching a show called Alone where people are dropped in the middle of nowhere and they have to survive. And I'm like, listen, I don't need for you people to spontaneously put yourself in this situation.
That is funny.
Yeah. Well, it was hysterical.
Your sister and I feel like are peas in a pod. That is totally something I would do.
You're kindred spirits. But yeah, I went from like laughing hysterically at their spontaneous adventure to like getting legit scared. Like, save your battery. Do you know where you are? Have you left any sort of markings?
Right.
You know, can you get back to the car? Find the car. That's your new mission.
But hey, do it all for the gram, right?
Oh, they did it. They got some amazing video and pictures, and I've shared it on our Facebook page.